On that note, let's also play out some excerpts from Prime Minister's very significant speech today. In a strong statement at the United Nations, Prime Minister Modi reiterated India's UNSC bid, questioning how long the nation will be kept out of UN's decision-making structure. Listen in to what the Indian Prime Minister had to say.
Today, the people of India are concerned whether this reform process will ever reach its logical conclusion. For how long will India be kept out of the decision-making structures of the United Nations? This is a country which is the largest democracy of the world. This is a country with more than 18% of the world population.
Now, the Indian Prime Minister also questioned the role of the United Nations in the pandemic response of the world. Listen in to what Prime Minister said.
पिछले 8-9 महीने से पूरा विश्व कोरोना वैश्विक महामारी से संघर्ष कर रहा है। इस वैश्विक महामारी से निपटने के प्रयासों में संयुक्त राष्ट्र कहां है? एक प्रभावशाली रिस्पांस कहां है? अध्यक्ष महोदय, संयुक्त राष्ट्र की प्रतिक्रियाओं में बदलाव, व्यवस्थाओं में बदलाव, स्वरूप में बदलाव आज समय की मांग है।
I'm also joined in by our political editor, Mr. Karthikeya Sharma, who's joining us on the phone line for more analysis. Let's quickly go across to Karthikeya. Karthikeya, that indeed was a very powerful speech made by the Indian Prime Minister, who is the first speaker at today's session. How do you analyze his speech today? And how do you actually view the Prime Minister hitting out the issue of terrorism, considering a lot was being spoken about in terms of that, of terrorism being an agenda during his speech?
You see, there are a couple of themes which have been very Prime Minister Narendra Modi has been consistent. One is terrorism, and the second is the reforms in the United Nations. People forget that this is not sort of a knee-jerk reaction. Prime Minister has chosen to make the issue of terrorism, and Prime Minister has chosen to make the issue of structural reforms in United Nations a very important theme. I remember, you know, it is a long time back, but now can be shared in public. In 2015, Prime Minister went through a set of interactions with journalists, and I also had the opportunity to meet him over the period, over that period where he met a number of journalists at Arun Jaitley's, late Arun Jaitley's residence. And one of the questions which popped up was on UN. And Prime Minister suddenly said that, why don't you ask me anything about UN reforms? You know, I have been asked a lot of questions of what India intends to do vis-a-vis Pakistan, Afghanistan, other countries. I think the question you people need to ask me is about reforms. And then Prime Minister spoke to us for 15 to 20 minutes in 2015 about what should be India's place in the United Nations. So I think this is something which is very close to Prime Minister Narendra Modi's heart, that India must have its place in the high table of the world politics. India must have a place in United Nations, not just because of the fact that it's a big country, it's populous, but because of the contributions it has made. India is probably one of the countries which has never started a war on its own. India is one country which has been very steadfastly committed to the message of peace, non-interference in other countries. India has been a victim of terrorism. Look at the difference of language between Imran Khan and Prime Minister Modi.
That's exactly what I was coming to, Karthikeya. How do you analyze India's stance, and how dignified do you think was the speech, considering unlike Imran Khan, the Indian Prime Minister did not rake up any, you know, any territory disputes. He did not name any country. He did not name any particular world leader. And it was yesterday only that the US, Russia and China were in fact trading allegations over the politicization and responsibility of the pandemic.
Yes, very rightly asked. Akanksha, if you want to be a big leader, you have to behave like a big leader. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi behaved like a big leader. You know, if you look at even in a very bipartisan approach, if you look at the speeches of the Chinese premier or you know, the American president, there were big issue speeches despite subtle indications to what their national interest was. Like, for example, if even for the China to say, we are not interested in hot and cold war, we know that what China has done in Ladakh, but then there were broad sweeps, you know. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed big issues. The reason why I'm giving these examples is that if you are a big leader, you address big issues. Small leaders will address small and regional issues. Prime Minister has behaved like a big leader. He has spoken about the big issues. He has spoken about the larger issues. And see, most important issue is the structural reform of the United Nations. United Nations is a product of the World War II and Britain War institutions. It succeeded League of Nations, which collapsed because of successive wars which took place and the way unfair treaties were in existence post-World War I. It was the United Nations which has sustained itself as an international organization over a long period of time. But then the politics, the weight, the dominance of countries have shifted. China has emerged. India has emerged. You know, the sort of rise which countries saw of Japan and the tiger economies, that has taken place, but not to that quantum. So India must be given that due place. So the Prime Minister broadly has commented on bigger issues which affect everyone. Like, as you said, issue of vaccine. You know, Prime Minister could have chosen to address in a very nationalist way. You know, there have been a lot of comments by a lot of people in the medical community that vaccine nationalism should not become a norm and vaccine should be available for everyone, poor, rich countries, everyone. And because the fear is that the rich countries might corner vaccine. But the Prime Minister, if you look at the way he spoke on the issue of vaccine, it was from a humanistic perspective. He did not speak from just New Delhi's perspective. He spoke from a global perspective of the contribution, of ability of India to help mankind, humankind, fight the problem of COVID-19. So I think for me, the depth of the speech lay in the fact that it was very global in nature. It was very diverse. And it spoke, it had broad brushes, you know. It wasn't, to use the word, very limited in the way in which Imran Khan raised issues, half of which were actually non-factual.
All right. Thank you, Karthike. Those were some very, very precious inputs and very well said. The Prime Minister actually highlighted India's diverse and very versatile role and its contribution on the world stage. Thank you so much, Karthike, for bringing us on all those details.